Hey, hello again. Happy Sunday to you. It is marathon day here in New York, and my apartment happens to be right near the finish line, so as a consequence, I get to see everybody staggering on home and limping, and actually saw a poor guy drop dead a couple years back, but luckily there's been none of that, thank goodness. We're on the ground in Phoenix at Sky Harbor International Airport here, or KPHX, or as Frugal would say, Kilo Papa Hotel X-Ray, and I, for life of me, don't know why I keep making fun of Frugal for that. A, he's a nice guy. B, he's got a good channel. And C, that's the correct way to say it. But somehow or other, it sounds ridiculous coming out of his mouth. And I don't know why that should be, but that's more my problem than his. Anyway, this airport is by Mr. X6, and it is awfully good, and it is awfully terribly free. Also, as you can see, we're surrounded by planes that are somewhat bigger and seem to be elbowing us out of the way here, but we'll survive. We're going to take a short hop to Los Angeles because it's just a nice flight, and why not? And maybe play a little music, and maybe, naturally, of course, hang on, stand by. Sometimes when you reinstall your operating system, the IXEG 737 reverts to the wrong view, so pardon me, hang on. Little annoyances here. It is not 60 degrees, it should be 80 degrees for a field of view, and now, there we go. That's a reasonable field of view, I think. Not bad, not too low. This is a complaint of, I think it's helipilot, Chris, is that, or maybe it's AeroSim Rush, but sees too many videos and they look like this. And you can't fly an airplane that way. You fly an airplane looking out the window most of the time, one hopes. Anyway, some news since last we spoke. I've been offline for a little while because I roasted a motherboard. And roasted a motherboard because, let's see, how do I open up the saved route here? I did save a route. And, I know how. You just type in Kilo, sorry, Frugal, Papa Hotel X-Ray, and we're going to Los Angeles, KLAX, and stick that in company route, and I will bet you that that saves our route. Now, let's see. Is there a route in there? Well, yes, there's the middle of the route in there. It doesn't save SIDS and STARS, so of course we have to put them in. And we're going to be departing off of runway 6 using the ISO 4. And 2-6, there we go. Bim, boom, execute that. And we're going to be arriving on the C-View. I think it's the CV2, and it is, and we're going to be landing on, since we're U.S. Air / American, we'll land on 25 left on the south side of the field, and that all looks good. I'll just give an extended center line here of 5 miles. That's an interesting little... you know what? You know why? Here's why. Hang on. This is the problem. I forgot to choose ILS 25 right. There, 25 left. There we go. And now it's going to not ask for anything else. And we're going to use a C-view transition because that's where we're coming in. And let's make sure we have... I hate when that happens. Let's try that one more time. Got fat finger syndrome. One more time. C-view 2, yes. ILS 25 left. Yes, with the sea view transition. Yes. Okay, now we're good to go. And let's go to our legs page. All right. So here is our departure. Let's get rid of that. All right. Here is our departure. ISO. And then we're going to Blythe. And then here, and then 29 palms, TNP, VOR, and we're going to start our descent, and our altitudes are not put in here because we haven't put in our performance figures, so let's do that. Origin, destination, runway all set, route set. I'm sort of doing this backwards and sideways, but... there we go. Ground services. We want 20,000 pounds of fuel, which should get us there and give us about 45 minutes of reserve time as well. Boom. And yeah, let's fly with 108.2 for our gross weights. We're not unbelievably heavy. Okay, done. 20, we're going to do 19.8 because the APU is going to burn some fuel and we're going to have some taxi fuel. Let's get our correct weights. Cruising today at 320 flight level. And transition altitude should not be 5, it should be 18,000. Done. And we'll climb out of here on climb one, and we're not going to derate at all. Done. Bim. Bam. Boom. All right. 262838. Set that to. And we'll slam these to 80 so we have a reminder. 2-4, let's get zoomed in here a little bit so we can see what we're doing. Alright, 120, 22, 24, 26. 28 for the VR. Right there. There's our V2 speed. Cleanup speed, there we go. Boom, boom, this is our flight plan right here. And our weather is clear, 3000. All right, I'm at it to turn on our flight director captain's priority. And heading, and 258 is gonna be our runway heading. Stick that in. Boom, boom. All right, and 3,000 for the altimeter. There we go. And that squares with the airfield elevation. That's good. All right, we're kind of doing this quick and dirty, mainly because I want to fly quick and dirty. Mainly because... we're just 2 days out from the elections, and as some of you know, I work in TV news, and, pardon me, hang on, let me blow some cigar ashes off of my controller. Wow, that's embarrassing. Many of you know, I work in TV news, and it has been just more than a little bit weird, so I've had well more than enough here. And I can't wait for it to be over. And I've mainly been getting through all of this as well I should on I was going to say the three C's, but it's the two C's and the one K, and that is cocktails, Klonopin, and classic movies. We're going to set our altitude to 320. And our airfield elevation in Los Angeles is 100. Done and done. We're showing dual bleed here, so what I'm going to do is turn off our engine bleeds because they're not, engines aren't turning, it doesn't matter. And gonna turn our packs. These in-between switches here with the three positions are very easy to get wrong. There we go. Turn our packs to auto. Done and done. Recert fan is on. Let's get people seated. APU is turning and our APU voltage is, there we go, volting. All right, so we've set our CDU. And actually what I'm going to do is, did I not set my reserves? Let me check. Pardon me, I did not. Set 4,000 for reserves. And 85 for our cost index. Double check. That's correct. That's good. All right, now, set our legs. Now, as you can see right here as we scroll through this, here is our runway heading, climbing to this altitude, then turning ever so slightly to the right, and flying on out. And we're just looking at our altitudes here. Those are all reasonable. Let's see, 320, so it's 5,000 feet. And 36 miles, that's doable. And then another 4,200 feet and 13 miles, and that's doable. And then 6,000 feet and 19 miles, and that is doable. And then 1,000 feet and 4 miles, and that is doable. But now, you see right here, we go from 14,000 to 17,000, and that is a no good. So let's do this. Let's set this for 14,000 or above as well. We do that by 14,123 for 14,000 and A for above. And plunk that into there. And that is done. And let's see. 3.5 miles. For 1,000 feet, that's good. 3.5 for another 1,000 feet, that is good. 3.3 for another 1,000 feet, that is good. 2,000 feet for 9, that will work. And on down, alright, that's good, but I think we need to be just a little bit slower, so at gate, we're going to do 220 slash. I want to be able to get in at least flaps 5 right here. And that is fine there. We're far enough out. That's good. Bim, bam. And actually, by Lima, I want to be at 150 as well. And oh, crap. Hang on. Oh, that's fine. 150 here. Because that's going to be my flaps 15 and gear down right there. And that's good, and that's good. All right, by here I'm going to be flying manually, so it doesn't really matter that much. Make sure everything else is sane and reasonable. And it is, so that is good. The other thing I'm going to do is make sure my controls work properly. And being typical for this plane and X plane, they don't. So this is supposed to be my reversers. So I've had to do this before. Joystick and equipment. Calibrate. Okay, throttle is good. toggle this on and off. Okay. Sorry for putting you through this, but it's actually supposed to work. Doesn't always. Alright, that's good. Rudder trim is good. Alright. Anyway. This is, of course, 1980s U.S. Air colors. Before that, I grew up in Pittsburgh, so you see U.S. Airways here. U.S. Airways before that was U.S. Air. Before that, there were identical colors, and it was Allegheny. And Allegheny was from a merger of a bunch of airlines, including, I think, North Central and Mohawk and All American Airways, but Allegheny it was. And Allegheny was sort of the Southwest of its time. It used small planes, quick turnarounds, lots of stops, and it had open seating like Southwest. So you'd get your boarding pass and you'd run in and try and grab a seat. And if you were like me, traveling with a brother and sister and two parents, it was a real, let's see, what's the word for this? There's an aviation term, I'm grasping for it. Pig fuck is what it was. It was a, it was a South Carolina pig fuck. And if you've ever been to South Carolina, you know that nobody throws a pig fuck like South Carolina does. I have no idea what that means. Anyway, so they changed the name to U.S. Air. And of course, the reason why, one of the reasons why they did was because people had been calling Allegheny Agony. So they said, aha, we'll change our name to U.S. Air. And of course, the first thing that we asshole customers did was redub U.S. Air Unscheduled Airlines. So didn't do much good. But anyway, they ended up buying or being bought by America West, and then the combined airline ended up buying American Airlines and or merging with American Airlines. And as a consequence, they still have a big hub in Phoenix, although being American, they've got a big hub in Los Angeles and in Chicago and Dallas-Fort Worth, of course. So we're going to get the hell out of here. I'm pretty much done with bitching about Allegheny Airlines because I figure that that ship has sailed, but I'm just going to open this because why the hell not? Because it's cool. I feel like sticking my head out the window here. And just get the push going here. Do nose left. We're going to go out to runway 26 and start up number 2 while we do that. There goes the jetway. And there we go. All right. We're going to use the left ignitions today. There's number 2 starting up. Give it a listen. Very sweet. We don't have far to taxi. I arranged it that way. All right, and we are looking for, well, actually right about that. Bring in the fuel, and we should get a start. We'll just monitor that, especially the temps, which will shoot up and then they'll come back down. Turbine engines sometimes peak on startup. That's how efficient they are. Looks like we've got a good start. In a second, we'll get starter cut out. There we go. And then we'll start number 1. That's sort of an overlapping start. It's basically starting them as quickly as we can. All right. Here we go. And we're good to go on the push. And we're good to go on the start. There we are. like we got two good starts. Ah, what a mighty noise they make, too. Here, look at them turn here. It's pretty damn slick. All right, that's good. Yes, we do have two good starts. Nice. All right. Turn our main buses on. We'll check Gen 1. Got volts there. Check Gen 2. We got volts there. Done and done. All right, that's good. Turn our taxi lights on. All right. Looks like we are good. Turn our pitot heats on. Boom. And we're going to take off with bleeds on. Kill our APU. Kill our APU bleeds. Okay, looks good. Now, the problem here is that my reversers work now. All right, that's good. All right, we'll set our flaps. Flaps 5, and trim should be 3.6. Which is never easy to do on this thing. It's simple, but it's not easy. All right, so there's 3. That's about 3.6. Good. All right, altimeter is set. The initial constraint of the SID is 8,000. Expect cruising altitude 3 minutes after departure. So the restriction really is not going to be for long. That is set. I'm going to turn our transponder on, squawking mode C, that's good. And, all right, we are good. Let me just check our trim here. Okay, that works, that's good. It's our rudder trim. All right, check our controls. They are good. All right, that is fine. Get into map mode here. Turn that on. COM 1. Get rid of all this other crap. Boom, boom, boom. Alright, I think we're ready to go. Heading select. Actually, you know what I should do. Since we're not going to be using a decision height, we'll use a decision altitude in LA. Get rid of the radio altimeter. And squawk something reasonably appropriate. All right, there we go. Anyway, so I think I mentioned I roasted my X99 motherboard. I overclock it a little bit, and a voltage regulator gave way. And this is how I handled it. I looked down, and I sniffed a little bit, and I said, let me see if I can do this right.
Something's burning, ain't it? Something's burning, yeah.
Well, yeah. My voltage regulator, or one of them, was burning. Well, not burning, sort of roasting slowly and giving off smoke. Smoking. And so I've replaced it with a ASUS Z170 Deluxe with a 6700K chip, so I'm giving up two cores, but the old one I could clock to about 44, 45. This one I can clock to 47. So it seems to be performing very, very nicely. And we seem to be getting good frames. So I can't complain. As we make our way out to runway 26. And again, this is 100% freeware scenery. It's pretty damn good. Mr. X does great work. So does Greg, who goes by the online name of GPB500 on xplane.org. He also will make his airports and updates to his airports available to you sort of on a subscription basis for a donation. And the donation is whatever you want, which is great. Now, I seem to have run into a slight problem here in the sense that, you know what? This is the runway. It just happens to be a displaced threshold or slightly. Let's get our landing lights on, taxi lights off. Logo strobe, wheel wells on, pressurization to flight, sparklers to continuous, yaw damper on, APU gen should be off, all the other gens should be on, galley is on, power is good, heats are on. And again, APU bleed is off, engine bleeds are on, packs are on auto. All right, looks copacetic. Flight director is armed, airspeed is set, heading is set. Initial altitude is set. V-speeds are set. FMA is enunciating properly. The radar on, turn terrain on. Pardon me, transponder is set for altitude. And TCAS is set for TARA. Brakes are set to RTO. Engines look fine. Flaps are set at 5. Trim is set at 3.6. I don't know about you, but I think we're good to go. Arrival end is checked. Departure end is checked. Is my strobe on? My strobe is on. Yes, it is. All right, good. Am I just missing the end of the runway here, or am I crazy, or both? Yes, I'm missing the end of the runway, which is right over here. This is a turnaround area. There we go. All right, I'm just going to say we've been positioned over there for overflow traffic, so obviously, naturally, of course. Some. All right, there are the big numerals 2 and 6, so runway is identified. All right, it matches our runway heading, and that is good. All right, arm the auto throttle. Flight directors are set. Autopilot is off. V-speeds are set. Gear down. Brakes RTO. Speed brakes off. Flaps set. I think we're good to go. Up come the throttles. Checking the power, and it is nice and stable. Toga is set. I'm just going to match up our ghost throttles. And we're going to have at it. right, airspeed's alive, coming up on 80. We got 80. All right, takeoff power is set now. And coming up on V1 and rotate. A little bit quick there. Oh, birds, shit. All right, let's see what we lost. It looks like we've lost both engines. All right. This is not good. Okay, manual braking. All right. Well, that's one way to do it. Let's get off the runway. Check our engines. Wow. Dual engine failure. That's about the worst time you could do it. Luckily, we had a long runway. All right. Well, we are dead in the water there. That was a very hard landing, too. Yeah, let's just see what that looked like. Holy crap. All right. I don't even think there are birds in Phoenix, to tell you the truth. All right, let's see what that looked like. All right. All is normal. And away we went. And look at that. And no power. Zip. Zilch. Niente. I should have gotten the nose down earlier. You notice how I got the stick shaker? Not much to be done. And there we go. Luckily, we weren't going very fast, and luckily the runway's about 12,000 feet long. All right, shall we do that again? Let's do that again. Alright, so everything is frickin' dead in the water. Just get the parking brakes on. And aircraft. Equipment failures. There we go. You know, I think I'm gonna have to reload the aircraft. So let's do that. Let's see. Pre-flight. All right, this time we'll set it up with ready to go. That should reload us. There we go. Alright, we'll get that set on RTO. Alright, you know what we're gonna have to do? Boom, boom, boom. Turn on the APU. Let's get restarted here. Let's get this party restarted. Wow, look at that. No, you know, I'm going to have to reload the aircraft. Holy crap. That was a true blue shit show there. All right. Let's do U.S. You know what? Let's just do old United Airlines. That'll be fun. You know what? I don't think we have it. Let's do Piedmont. That's another part of American Airlines. Or what is now American Airlines? Tell you, you try to fly a good flight, and what happens? All right, looks like we got power. Yes, we do. That's good. Let's see what kind of fuel. There we go, 107.6. Sorry, I got to reprogram the FMC. 320. Boom. 4. Boom. Cost index 85. Boom. And one limit. We'll climb on climb 2. Take off. Boom. 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 Those will go to 80. 138 is set. 126, 128, 200, 3000, set, boom, boom, done. All right, wow. Okay. Parking brake, is it on? Yes, it is. Good. Alright. Try again here. PHX. And KLAX. Boom. And what runway are we near? We seem to be at the cargo. Oh, I don't want to be in these colors. Oh, anyway. We'll do 25 left. That'll work. Yep. All right. All right. Done. K. P. H. X. K. L. A. X. Company route. Done. Activate. Execute. Okay. Departure arrival. All right. Departure is 04. 25 left. Blythe transition. Execute. Okay. Departure arrival. Arrival. Oddly enough, on the same runway. 25 left. Seaview 2. Transition Seaview. Done. And done. Legs. Clear the disco there. And we have to clear up the illogical altitude right over there. Pardon me. 1,000 or above right there. Done. Clear up the speed problem right here. Let's do... Boom. Done. Done. And 150 right there. Boom. Boom. Back. Actually, make that 200 at gate. Let's see. Yes, make that 200. We don't want to be crazy. Well, no crazier than we already are. Done. Radar on. Terrain on. Let's get everything else ready to go. Seatbelt signs are on. Flight. Reset this to 320. Reset this to 100. Yaw, damper, fuel, pumps, taxi lights. Engine is on. Let's make sure we're taking from the right bus. We are. Generator 1, juice. Generator 2, juice. All right, that's good. All right. Heats are on. Pitot is on. Our temps squared away. There we go. Recirc fan is on. Packs are on auto. Bleeds are on. Pressurization is on. Flight. All right, let's go back to the runway. And let's try not to hit any birds now. Set flaps 5. Auto brakes are set already. And really good looking scenery. All right, we'll taxi past these KC-135s here because they're pretty cool. Here on the wrong side of the tracks. Let's see, flight director should be on, captain's priority. In heading select mode, there we go. Panel recall is set, checked. Height controls are free and clear. And the living is easy. Now, in the real world, we probably would have waited just a little bit longer for our brakes to cool, but we got no reason to care. Check my presh, as the kids say. Flight, boom, boom, that's good. Check the old presh. Alright, so we'll get clearance to cross right here. And we will. Because they know we are, we're now running late here, so we're just going to do the old southwest taxi here. And whip around here. Words of the sheriff, new sheriff in blazing saddles. Excuse me. While I whip this out. All right, that's useless. And that's useless. It's missing a bunch. All right, there is our runway, there's our windsock, looks good. And we'll get set to go in 1 second. Our strobe's on. All right, let's get going. Try our best not to screw it up this time. I've already screwed it up. There we go. All right. right, waiting for the airspeed to come alive, and it just does. There's 80 knots. Trying to avoid the birds this time. Okay. And V1 and rotate. And positive rate. And gear up. Fly this till 1600 feet. And let's get into LNAV mode right now. Second left turn. Okay, looking good. A second, we'll get our... There we go. There's our thrust reduction. We'll pop into VNEV mode. And pitch down and clean up. And we'll just trim, because every single configuration change in this airplane, you need to retrim. But once you do, it's pretty damn stable. Alright, there we go. LNAV and VNAV, and we're pitching down for about 240. Get our brakes off and get our sparklers back to off. And get our gear to off. And just fly the airplane and enjoy ourselves. Enjoy the view. That is Phoenix. That looks good. Climbing at 4,000 feet per minute, we are above the birds at this point. Alright, we're at our 8,000 feet, but we're going to actually be cleared up higher. Our VNAV back in. And it means business, let me tell you. Let's trim up a little bit. Now I'm flying the, as it were, the flight suggester. I'm not jamming the nose like that up to hit the target. I'm still flying the plane like I'm flying the plane. So if I start to drift just a little bit off the flight director target, then I will correct judiciously, I won't correct insanely. Okay, looking nice. Alright, 10, that is the magical time for flight simulators. Get our lights off. And actually what I really want to do is check this, and it's fine. We'll let people smoke. And sometimes that lights up and sometimes it doesn't. And we're going upstairs at about 290, which is nice. And again, I'm just flying this with my fingertips, really. It doesn't take a lot. Once you trim it right, it does not take much. If it did, we'd all be in trouble because pilots aren't necessarily that good. It is a complicated thing to be an airline pilot, and it demands good judgment and a certain amount of unflappability and certain flying skills. But if it were as hard as all that, then airplanes would be falling out of the sky every day, and they aren't. It's a hard thing to do really well, from what I've observed. and it's a hard thing to sort of get everything as right as you can get it, but it's not unbelievably hard to do adequately. So as you don't hurt yourself or others, and so that you get where you're going on time, and so that you follow the procedures and you stay legal. If it were otherwise, then nobody would do the job, and nobody would want to do the job, and nobody would want to fly. So that is no insult whatsoever to really, really good airline pilots, and it's certainly no insult to really good pilots, the Bob Hoovers and the Chuck Yeagers of this world. It's an incredibly hard thing to do and make it look like an art form. But like anything else, it's not unbelievably hard to do once you've been trained and once you know it, as I've observed, not as I've done directly, because my flying experience is relatively nil. I mean, it's, you know, a few hours over 20 years, coming up on 180 here. Just set standard altimeter. But if it were crazy hard, then in my real business, which is TV news, we'd be very busy, and we aren't. Thank goodness. All right, so we are, let's see what our outside air temperature is. It is about zero, and we're coming through some moisture, so we'll get our engine anti-ice on just in case. That'll rob us of a little bit of climb power, but not much. And our engine temps look fine. That is good. And this is ortho scenery, so it's photographic scenery. And it looks magnificent. And I'm just flying the flight director here, and we're making our way to ISO, which is the end of our SID from Phoenix. So, we are looking good today. Get all this crap off here. And this airplane has a lot of positive stability. So for instance, if I go like this and upset it, it will basically hold that turn and then ever so slightly go wings level. See, watch, see? Yeah, you know. Not positive stability, it's not negative stability, it's neutral stability. So it'll just stay where you put it, which is good. If you fly certain airplanes in X-plane, you'll notice that they're very busy, and you have to control, and you have to stir the paint a lot, and the blessed and beautiful thing, if you get in a real airplane, as long as it's rigged okay, which means as long as all the connections between your controls in the cockpit and the control surfaces are balanced out and connected properly and have the proper tensions and pressures on them and all the rest of that, which is called rigging, and as long as they're consistent with one another, in other words, so that left and right ailerons aren't drastically different in tensions so that it's not neutral. Generally speaking, the airplane can be flown, as long as you trim it out and you don't fall asleep, can be mostly flown with either hands off or a very light touch on the controls. And the same is true with this. I'm just trimming a little bit here because it's nosing us down to speed us up a little bit. But other than that, we're hitting a little bit of turbulence. I'm just going to put the autopilot in. All right. And we're going to spin ourselves up to our final cruising altitude here, which I should have done earlier. All right. And that should do us a cruise climb right now. And there we go, and that's good. Throttles are forward, power's around 92%, that's climb power, and that's fine. Get rid of that. And, well, looks like we're going through some bumpies here as we go over the desert. There's not much to see. And what I'd like to do, with apologies to viewers in a few countries around the world that get really persnickety about copyrights and so forth, I just want to play some music because I'm kind of in the mood, and you might like it. This is R.E.M.'s greatest hits here. Let me just pop it up. It's kind of up for something that... just is a nice soundtrack here. Before I do anything else, let me just check my levels. I'm sure they're a little bit wrong. I'm still diddling around with this because it should be fine. Shut up a little bit.
Napoli 21, checkers and chess. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Fred Lassie in a breakfast mess. Yeah, 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 yeah. Let's play Twister, let's play Risk. Yeah, 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 yeah. I'll see you in heaven if you may. About this one, tell me, are you locked in the punt? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis? Are we losing touch? If you believe they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe there's nothing up this sleeve, nothing. Walking with the staff of wood. Yeah, 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 yeah. Newton got mean by the apple wood. Yeah, 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 yeah. Egypt was troubled by the horrible ass. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Charles Darwin had the gold. About this one, tell me, are you locked in the pond? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis?
Hey, baby, are you having fun?
If you believe they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe there's nothing up this sleeve, nothing is cool. Here's a little ghost for the offering. Yeah, 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 yeah. Here's a truck stop instead of St. Peter's. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mr. Andy Kaufman's gone wrestling. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now, Andy, did you hear about this one? Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Hey, Andy, are you goofing on Elvis?
Hey, baby, are we losing touch?
If you believe they put a
public service announcement followed me home the other day. I paid it, never mind. Go away. Shit so thick you can stir with a stick. Free Teflon, whitewash presidency. We're sick of being jerked around. Wear that on your sleeve. Broadcast me a joyful noise into the times, Lord, count your blessings. We're sick of being jerked around. We all fall down. Have you ever seen the televised invited subcommittee prize investigation dance? Those answer pants glances, right, look behind the eyes. It's a hallowed, hollow anesthetized. Sit my own ass, screw these guys. Smoke and mirror lock down. Broadcast me a joyful noise into the times, Lord, count your blessings. The papers wouldn't lie. I sigh, not one more. It's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day. Please, it's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day. Please, we're dug in deep. The price is steep. The auctioneer is such a creep. The lights went out, the orange dry. We blamed it on the other guy. Sure, all men are created equal. Here's the church, here's the steeple. We stay tuned, we cut to sequel. Ashes, ashes, we all fall down. Broadcast me a joyful noise into the times, Lord. Count your blessings, ignore the love of fears. Oh, this means war. It's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day. It's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day. Got being jerked around. We all fall down. It's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day. Please, it's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day. Please, it's been a bad day. Please don't take a picture. It's been a bad day.
Twilight, What's the Frequency, Kenneth. That was written for Dan Rather, about a guy who tried to beat him to death while screaming, "What's the frequency, Kenneth?" And we're coming up on 29 Palms, even though this song is all the way to Reno.
Dusted the non-believers and challenged the laws of chance. Now sweet, you're so sugar sweet, you may as well have had kicked me fastened on your sleeve. Know what you are, you're gonna be a star. You know what you are, you're gonna be a star. Wait, it's written on your feet.
Star. all of you and all of me, fluorescent stars. Some of them they surprise. The bus driver went to write this 4 a.m. this letter. The fields of poppies, little pearls. All the boys and all the girls, sweet tooth, each and every one a little scary. I said your name. I wore it like a badge of teenage film stars. Hash bars, cherry mash, and tinfoil tiaras. Dreaming of Maria Callas, wherever she is. This fame thing, I don't get it. I wrap my hand in plastic to try to look through it. Maybelline eyes and girls, boy moves. Can take you far. The star thing, I don't get it. Tastes like fear, adrenaline, the princess near. It tastes like fear. Will you live to 83? Will you ever welcome me? Will you show me something that nobody else has seen? Smoke out, dream, here comes a flood. Anything within the blood, these corrosives do their magic slowly, sweet. Fall, eat it, dream. Just another chain cuts and dents, they catch the light. Aluminum, make a sling. I don't wanna disappoint you, I'm not here to anoint you. I would lick your feet, but is that the sickest move? I wear my own crown, sadness and sorrow. Who'd have thought tomorrow would be so strange? My loss, here we go again. And starry, some of them they surprise. I can't look it in the eyes. Second off, Spanish fly out of the kerosene, cherry flavored neck and car. I can smell the sorrow on your breath, sweat, victory, song, smell thing. I got it. Aluminum, it tastes like fear. Tastes like fear, adrenaline, pulls us near. Tastes like fear, pulls us near. It tastes like fear,
is the Salt Sea over there, and Thermal and Bermuda Dunes is right over that way. And we're going to head up to Thermal and then actually to Palm Springs, which will be right about there. This is our arrival, and we're already on it right there. This is the end of it, and from there we will pick up the ILS approach to 5 left. Thermal, sorry. And we're coming up right around Palm Springs. Bermuda Dunes is right down here somewhere.
Receiving
this is a very pretty song.
3 a.m. Staff cuts have socked up the overage. Directives are posted, no callbacks, complaints.
All right, so here we go.
Just
monitor our descent here. We've set a platform on it. This Bermuda Dunes right there.
Headache, great day, sleeper.
You know what? That could be. Is that Palm Springs?
Day, sleeper.
It's hard to say. No, you know what? That's Palm Springs.
The bull and the bear marking.
No, that's Bermuda Dunes.
They're leading the blind with their international glory.
right over there.
On the screen, I work at night. I see today with a loose print. Pray my night is colored. Headache, gray, don't wake me so much. Day sleeper.
This is a beautiful song. There's another one coming up that you'll hear it in a minute, is a total homage to Beach Boys' Pet Sounds. You'll know the one.
I can't even say why. Fluorescent, flat, caffeine light. It's furious balancing. I'm the screen, the blinding light. I'm the screen, I work at night. I see the day with the newsprint. Pray my night is colored. Headache, gray, don't wake me so much. The ocean machine is set tonight. I'll squeeze into Helen and Valentine. My bed is pulling me. Gravity, day sleeper, day.
Our V-speeds. As we come through the Inland Empire here, which is
stop.
enter the Inland Empire and proceed down our SID.
Sort of, this is a tribute to the tokens, the Lion Sleeps at Night.
This here is the place.
And that's Riverside Airport right there.
Intercept the localizer.
I don't pick up the side while you sleeps in a car. Call me and try to wake her. 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 Call me and try to wake her.
Yeah, let's see. This looks like Corona here. That's Ontario up to the right here. Sure looks like it. And that is San Bernardino. No, it's Chino. I don't know. Welcome to the LA Basin. And look at the lights. Holy crap.
Stand in the place where you live. Now think about direction. Wonder why you have it now. Stand in the place where you were. Now face west. Think about the place where you live. Wonder why you have it, people. If you are confused, check with the sun. Carry a compass.
Hey, we got a compass to help us along.
Stand in the place where you live. Now face
leaves will be falling. Listen to reason, season is coming. Stand in the place where you live.
Now face the
world. Think about direction, wonder why you have it.
Now
stand in the place where you were.
Now face the
world. Think about something.
Listen to reason,
reason is calling.
Your feet are going to be on the ground.
Your head is there to move you around.
So stand.
Now face no.
Think about direction, wonder why you have it.
Now
stand.
Now face no.
Think about the place where you live.
This is the Beach Boys tribute, and it really does sound, listen to the baritone sax. Perfect song for arriving in Los Angeles. And we're at 24 out, just waiting. There's the localizer.
listen to the orchestration here. This is just like Pet Sounds. And here's another pretty song. And there's our runway. Because American U.S. Air Terminal is a little bit far down.
500.
So I'm going to be one dot high here. Bit of our flight director.
400.
There we go.
100, 100, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10.
A little bit of pilot induced oscillation there. Go. And there's 80 knots, and we'll take the next high-speed turnoff. There we go. Get our speed brakes up. And we will cross 25 right and come on in here. That's the Tom Bradley terminal, so I probably misjudged it by one. But lovely flight, and look at this night lighting. This is just, this is what X-Plane is known for, and it is very good. Old AP going here. And there is ye old American Airlines terminal, although we're not technically in the right livery because of the reload after the bird strike, but pretend we did everything right. And we got a nice warm gate waiting for us. Expedite here. Turn off our taxi lights so we don't blind the poor gentleman here. There we go. Is he going to wave his hands? Well, I guess not. All right, well, at any rate, who needs his help? Welcome to Los Angeles, where it's just damn beautiful out. Well, let's see if we can get this guy to wave his arms. And I don't think he sees us. All right. Well, what are you going to do? Some people. People, you know, we tried. Anyway, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. There, leave you with one last look at Los Angeles here. This is just, no way else to describe it. This is just This is awesome. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. That is beautiful. All right. So, see you again real soon, and especially see you after the election. And take it easy. Bye-bye.